Hello guys, welcome to my Magic AFK training way. Let's get right into it. So first let's see what the XP rate actually is all about. We are gonna test two methods. We're gonna do Firebolt, of course, with Fire Surge. So we have a little bit of outer layer to outer layer. This guide of course is beginner friendly and medium tier friendly. Of course, see fit where you want to tune in. I highly recommend only to use the fire spell, so you can upgrade from fire strike to bolt to blast to wave to eventually surge. So this XP is about give or take 27k. Yeah, not with the harmonized exactly. And if you go towards here, this is 60k. My method actually is beyond recognition here. It definitely is a significant upgrade compared to what splashing is all about, right? It's exactly the same as splashing, but the XP rate is way better. It's just not traditional in a sense that you're used to. So I hope this will help you guys a lot. So you can use an imbued heart to make yourself a little bit higher over 99 or anything else. For example, you can just see how much you get boosted and thereby how much you increase, of course. It's always nice to have it. This is actually the most important, I think, since we are now going towards the weapon. And this is very important here. This staff provides 10% increased in accuracy and damage when casting from the normal or standard spellbook, which we're gonna do since we are Firewave. So that's quite up there. So the next thing I wanted to say is the Chaos Gauntlet. The Chaos Gauntlet only works on Chaos runes, but it is highly recommended. If you are going for a little bit cheaper alternative, this is the way to go. Just, you know, equip the gauntlets over the Torment Bracelet and you will be fine. The XP a hour is definitely less compared to, let's say, red runes or blue runes since you're using Chaos, but it makes up for it a little bit by using the gauntlets, so that's good. The Brimstone Ring theoretically is not needed. I just read through it and it gives, well, if you're not going for the Suffering defense way, this is your best in slot. Don't go for Sears. Sears is not it. Go for the Brimstone. Let's see. The Cave Kraken itself has 130 defense in magic, 300 in range. You really don't want a range here, of course. So melee is impossible since he has a little bit of tiles in between, so that's not gonna work. Magic bonuses, others, you can find them here. So let's say the Torment, right? You want the Ancestral boost, very nice. Don't go for the Ancestral Head, really go for Slayer Helm for more optional damage. So that was about it. Let's go into, oh wait, I don't think people really gonna use this, but let's read it anyway. If damage would have been taken when it affects active, is a minimum of 1 reduced, even on the original hit has been 1. So that makes us 0. This time the shield makes you especially useful against monsters, just as the Kraken and the Tentacles. You only have a maximum hit of 2. So that reduces by 1. That's why I had Elysium with me. Method 2 is Kraken, otherwise Cave Kraken. You need about 87 Slayer for this method to be useful. Kind of the requirements can be seen fit and you can upgrade or downgrade whatever you like. So let's go on and see what we're having. I quickly want to explain one thing. For example, you see here the mage set bonus, it's higher, but it doesn't affect the damage overall. So let's say I unequip this. This goes from 14 to 19. This is really what you want to boost up. You want to be as high as possible. So you can replace this with Ancestral, for example. You can downgrade everything that you like as well. For example, here the Arcane Spirit Shield. Very nice, but it's still 19. So it doesn't really work. So I would not highly recommend unless you want to go for extremely high attack bonus instead of other bonuses. I think a good way of, you know, being in between, as you guys can see, is a suffering. If you can't afford it and you're a baller, go with an Elysian. Otherwise, maybe a Tome of Fire to increase overall the XP a hour. So let's go in the perks really quickly here. If you see, I don't really think I'm gonna use the Suffering, since the Brimstone actually reduces the defense and we had 130, as you could see earlier. This makes it a little bit better. Let's say you don't have this, you know, and you're just going with Tome of Fire or Arcane. Optional uses are pretty much, let's say, this setup right here. It's beautiful, since they both stack in Healed Regent, and thereby you heal way easier backup than what you have had otherwise. Keep in mind, we did go from 19 to 12, so we lose about two or three, you know, max hit. So it's not optional, but it definitely is something nice to think about. I set the spell on Fire Surge. What you wanna do is attack one tentacle, so it spawns. I don't think auto attack is needed. And this is the whole trick. Look about the XP drops. They are quite magnificent. This is basically splashing in a nutshell, and it's so much better GP and hour wise. Let's say a splash is 100 GP. This is them, let's say maybe 20 a pop, you know, or maybe 30, since you don't get this by splashing. It actually rolls as if you had hit, but you didn't, you know? Yeah, I definitely go with the Brimstone here. So if you see, for example, what we're getting, it's about 70, 80k for now. I think we can do more. It's 91, yeah, it's definitely going up. So we are a minute or 2 minutes further along the way, and it's average between 100 and 102k a hour, it appears to be. So that is honestly amazing. Okay, sure, we're 95, but let's say you equip something like this, right? It still is beautiful to think about, since you boost your gauntlet hits by quite a lot. We can reset it and see what the XP is then. This is a couple minutes further. We average about 48, 49, sometimes 50, somewhere around there, a hour rate. And keep in mind, guys, it's only 35 that you require to use this spell with, of course, the gauntlet. I have one complaint. I'm 85 HP, so I might actually go over a Suffering or maybe an you know, Bracelet of Regen. It does decrease the effect of, you know, having the gauntlet, so it might be more like 35k, 40k instead of 50-ish. But it's not bad at all. It's not bad at all. So this is the other way. Feel fit to upgrade or downgrade to your own liking, of course, and try it out. So for the Nightmare Zone method, you want to look something like this. Don't mind the alley. I totally understand if you cannot pay for it. So go either for a Tome of Fire if you want to increase, you know, plus 9, very nice. But if you have a mage book, that's fine as well. You know, it's all good, pretty much. So I'm quickly going to show you what quests you have pretty much need to be done to make this better than splashing, yet much as AFGO as actually splashing. So for this method, you actually need to be 1 HP consistently, or close to, you know, whatever, low HP. I wouldn't recommend 100% of the time going for 1 HP, because that deflects the method of actually, you know, being AFK. Otherwise, every minute you need to do so. But just bring yourself to 1, go away when you see you're like 20 or 30 after, I don't know, half an hour or whatever. You think by yourself, okay, sure, I will do a couple of, you know, downgrades and it's fine. You can either do that with two different ways. The Locator Orb, which is Dragonslayer 2, very high requirement, so I wouldn't really recommend it, since the second one of all is way better in my opinion. It is the Rock Cake. You only need to free the Mountain Dwarf from a recipe for disaster. It's a super easy quest, it's a low level requirement as well. So Nightmare Zone, to actually start a Nightmare Zone kill, you need bare minimum of 5 monsters active and therefore 5 quests have been done. So with a little bit of calculation and you know, Google search and whatever, and asking around, this seems to be pretty much what you want to have. So it's Trapped Soul, which is the essence of Aseus. Then Counter Draenor, which is Vampire Slayer, free to play, very easy. Sand Snake, which is the Depth of Despair. King Roald is Which Lies Below. And then last but not least, the Kendall Mountain Daughter. You can optionally change whatever you like in all those quests, but I would highly recommend going for something like this. Don't go for the Corrupted Gauntlet or Felgar or whatever. They kill you when you're 1 HP. So watch out for that. So if you're new at Nightmares on, it's kind of a little bit of a trick, but something you want to look like this. Magic potions, super magic potions, a couple dressed absorption potions. This is definitely not a Nightmares on guide, it's a mage guide, so I cannot go in depth too much about it. I might make one then, you know, if people really want to. The thing actually is now, what you want to do is you go to, yeah, right click Dream, Rumble, you go to Normal. It says it's about 12k, it might be 16k if you don't have the questscape. It just deflects a little bit or reduces a little bit. What you want to do is you go towards this thingy here. You can buy from the chest actually all the potions and pick them from the barrels. Anyway, I'm gonna do everything off besides this one, that one gone away, this gun active, this active, candle, and the rest is all gonna be off. Keep in mind, every time you do a quest, it goes automatically on, so for the next time, you need to set it off if you want to do this more often. And let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The rest is all off. What you want to do is you eat up a little bit of those absorption potions. I marked this style to be the most AFK possible. It's literally in between those gear, I think it is, and then next to the blood mark. So you just go towards 1 HP. Cook cake is pretty much right click to make it more efficient. We are of course plus 1 in magic, high defense, so we should be alright. Auto retaliate on, you can say I need to eat a little bit more, you can go to 1000 if you want. And let's see what the XP is going to be. So I quickly wanted to say something. You can upgrade towards Dragon for a higher defense, but you need more, you know, magic gear. So for example, instead of Prayer that you might prefer, you kind of want to go for, you know, something like a Mage Book, Grim Ring or whatever, and you should be fine. You should be fine. So the XP looks like 91k-ish, 92. It's not bad at all. Keep in mind, Torak actually, or whatever Barrow set, I will not recommend. Because that decreases over time and you pay a little bit more and it might get broken and it's just annoying. So keep it up, Dragon the best, but you really don't need Dragon. Rune is plenty for this method. I don't really think I'm gonna need an Elysian even here. I just get zeros every time. So a red zero means there is an actually hit going on, and that's then, you know, a minus 1 point. You see all the way blue, 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 which basically means not even a single hit is going in. We're a couple minutes here and it's only 4, right? So you can theoretically say, hey, I keep 99. It really doesn't matter apparently, as long as you're somewhat tanky. And keep in mind, you need to be attack damage wise over 1, otherwise you keep on splashing, because you don't want to have that. You need to be at the plus side. So yeah, this is about an 90k, a little bit less than the other way, but it's very nice. You can of course say gauntlet, equip this one. We should really quickly do the 35 method, because most people are lower who are watching this, guys, obviously. So it's a couple minutes further and we average about 42k hour, 43, 42, 41, a little bit over 40. But that's not too shabby at all. It really is nice. Keep in mind, guys, you can upgrade where you see fit, but don't go for all the magic bonus, because the main priority about this is you don't want to get hit at all. So defense is priority here. And even on a spell which requires 35, and this is for, you know, low levels, very decent to get access. A 44k hour, perfect. I hope this guide, you know, helped you guys out, and enjoy your scape. Please like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell, and follow me on twitch.tv/qualitycontentstream. Have a good one. Bye.